I'm at the Pullman's Farmers Market, where it's a great day and everything here has been fresh picked and ready to buy. I'm here with bakery chef Lori Perrette, and we're going to be buying some great things to bake up. Hi, Lori.
Hi, Bonnie.
So, Lori, when you come to the farmers market, what do you come in looking for?
I think instantly I come toward the colors of the fruit. One, that's something I like to use whether I'm going to be working with my family and just having something to snack on or whether I'm baking. So I might start here with the apples. They're beautiful. I love the greens and the golds and the reds that they have. And I kind of think about, you know, could I use that in a pie or can I put it in a tart or maybe in a delicious chicken salad with some raisins or currants or something like
that. Stop, you're making me hungry. Lori's expert eye for fresh fruits and vegetables has been honed by 10-plus years working as a chef. She also owns Cakewalk Chicago, a bakery supply store located in the Beverly neighborhood. Now, do you use anything else other than fruit when you bake?
Yes, I do. Actually, the winter months are a perfect time for baking. You want things that are hearty and warm. And so even though these are beautiful, I actually have a different idea. I'm thinking about possibly some pumpkin.
Pumpkin?
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's go check them out.
All right.
Pumpkin? You know, it's funny because I thought pumpkins, you know, I don't really like pumpkin pie that much. So I always use it to just cut up and put it right there on my on my stew.
I agree. I'm not a big fan of the pumpkin pie either. I'm a sweet potato pie girl. but pumpkins are actually good for some other applications. They've got great nutritional value. And if we're going to be working with pumpkins, instead of the larger kind of jack-o'-lantern pumpkin that you were describing that you carve up and put it out, you want to work with a smaller pumpkin like a pie pumpkin. And pie pumpkin pumpkins tend to be a little bit meatier, so where the larger, more ornamental pumpkins have more seeds inside. So this will give us a lot to work with. And I think it does kind of scare people a little bit to think, how do I get inside this tough exterior for all that goodness? And so many of us tend to use canned pumpkin if we use it, but we'll find that it's not so hard to do and it's going to give a delicious flavor and things like that.
Well, I can't wait, you know. So how many do we need?
We're going to need a couple to work with. So how about you grab one and I'll grab one and we'll get started.
So Lori and I head to the kitchen to have some fun cooking with our farmers market finds. Okay, Lori, we picked up our gorgeous pumpkins and we're going to make pumpkin muffins.
Yes, we are. Something for brunch, something for an after-dinner treat. What we're going to do is we're going to take our pumpkin and instead of kind of hacking it up, which is very challenging, we're going to take a nice sharp kitchen knife, butcher knife, and we're going to pierce it. And it does take a little bit of effort to put it in and put it out, but what I'm doing is I'm getting it all the way down to where the seeds are because we don't want this to explode while it's in the microwave.
And how long do we put it, keep it in the microwave for?
You know, it depends. About 7 minutes per pound is the average.
After it's been, Lori makes short work of deconstructing the pumpkin. She trims off the top, cuts it into sections, scoops out the seeds and pulp, and then it's a snap to peel the rind. I grab an immersion blender and puree the pumpkin to make it easier to blend with our other ingredients. We'll need about 2 cups of pumpkin for our muffins.
We've got our pumpkin already, so now to the next steps of baking. I'm going to add my butter to the mixer bowl, and then we're going to add our sugar and cream it. And while we do that, can you crack our eggs?
I can crack eggs.
All right.
We ramp up the speed of the mixer, and then I begin to add the eggs one at a time. We stop to scrape down the bowl to make sure all the butter, sugar, and eggs are blended. Now, Lori, how did you get started into baking?
I used to like to watch my grandmother cook. She didn't do a lot of bakery goods, but I liked to kind of be in there when she was sniffing spices. She would mail order her spices, which I hardly knew anybody who would do that. And I really enjoyed it, so I decided that it was something I wanted to do, but on the baking part. So I went to culinary school about 10 years ago to study the science of baking, and I've just kind of been doing it ever since.
The final egg goes in. A little more scraping and beating, and we're ready to add the dry ingredients. Along with the flour, we toss in a heady melange of cinnamon, nutmeg, and pumpkin pie spices. Now it's time to mix in the pumpkin. And voila, the batter is finished. Lori has a no-fail trick up her pink sleeve that makes filling the muffin cups a breeze. An ice cream scoop ensures that the same amount of batter goes into each cup.
All right, you made quick work of that.
Thank you.
All right, let's get these cooking.
While the pumpkin muffins bake, we segue to the next step, which is to concoct a fluffy icing. We add whipping cream and vanilla to the bowl and let the mixer do the hard work. When the mixture gets light and airy, we toss in a cup of sugar. We let the cream whip for a couple more minutes until it forms nice, firm peaks.
All right, so now let's add our cream cheese to it. And so we're just going to call this Lori's not-so-low-fat, delicious cream cheese icing.
I like that.
A few additional turns in the mixer and the icing becomes smooth and creamy. Lori and I transfer the icing to pastry bags that we'll use to help us decorate the muffins. Speaking of the little golden gems, we need to take a moment to check on them.
I'm good. They've been baking for about 20 minutes, and I'm actually going to use the spring test. So I'm going to press down, and as long as it doesn't stay indented, then I know that the batter is fully done. So I'm going to go ahead and remove them. There will be some residual cooking as they cool off.
So you don't use the toothpick method?
I can never find a toothpick, Bonnie, so I just always use my finger. I know exactly where it is.
So the muffins are cooling, and the icing is resting comfortably in the plump little pastry bags. Just one more detail before we put everything together. It's time to create mini me pumpkins, which will give the homemade baked goods a masterly touch. Lori and I each take a small piece of marzipan dough, which she bought at the supermarket. We add a drop of orange food coloring and use some elbow grease to work it into the dough.
All right, so we're rolling in our hands, and then what we're going to do is we're just going to take a regular table knife.
Okay.
There you go. And we're going to make our little lines, you know, reminiscent of our pumpkin, just from top to bottom. I'm using the flat side,
okay,
not the serrated side.
Then we take a whole clove, press it into the top, and
I got a pumpkin!
Cue the tinny pumpkins, the icing, and the muffins. It's time to take your place in the spotlight on center stage.
So go ahead and grab a cupcake. And so we're going to use this delicious icing that we've made in our pastry bag. And basically what we want to do is to keep all the icing underneath our hand, because piping is all about pressure from the top.
Like that?
Like that. So go ahead and let's go ahead and start in the middle, and we'll just make a nice, beautiful little swirl like that.
So you squeeze while you're...
Yeah, oh, and you can actually build up on top. There's no wrong way to pipe. Beautiful.
Ta-da.
Ta-da.
Hey, I'm getting the hang of this, girl.
Fantastic. Yeah, that looks great. Look at you getting all fancy.
Hey.
That's what I like to see. You're having fun.
Yeah, the sooner we do this, the sooner I can eat it.
Oh, that's the method to your madness, huh?
You can create delicious baked goods like these at home, too. A trip to Cakewalk Chicago can help you get started.
Basically, what we do is we make it easy for people to create fantastic things for celebration. So we have muffin liners and food coloring and ready-to-use icings and all kinds of cool stuff, decorative cake pans, character pans, dragees, you name it, we have it for baking.
So now what do we do with the little pumpkins?
Let's go ahead and decorate. Just take some and put them on top. Which ones do you want?
I'm going to take mine.
Yes. Why don't you give it the place of honor in our decorative liner?
Isn't that gorgeous?
Beautiful.
Yes. Well, Lori, this is great. I mean, to see this from beginning to end, we went to a farmer's market, we actually picked up fresh pumpkin,
yes,
and then to bring it home and to see how to make it in something great and delicious is great.
It's a really cool thing, and I was happy to do it with you.
Ah, well, you know we got to toast this thing, don't you? All right, just take this down here.
Oh, that smells really
good.
To
pumpkins, the fall, and cooking.
Cheers.
Cheers.